is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to you out of a quick video. I wanted to let you guys know I got some new merchandise available, not just t-shirt anymore. I got different type of t-shirt, different type of shirts and logos that you can purchase on my spread shirt, and also hoodies now. We have expanded and added more to the channel and more merchandise for the brand. Thanks for supporting. It will be in the description and the links will be in the comment section below. Thanks for helping me and supporting the movement. Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis. I'm going to check out the video. Alec Burks is going to the Thunder. Nerlens Noel going to the Thunder. Mike Muscala going to the Thunder. They're making some acquisitions that give them some depth. They have been a deeper team. They still have to make some more moves because I think the Thunder are getting overtook in the Western Conference, as we don't really know how good Russ going to be. He had a drop off each season since his MVP season. Even though he did have more talent, he didn't have the same effectiveness that he usually did. And they didn't even win 50 games the last couple seasons either. And that's with and without Carmelo. So that's not an excuse either. So I really want to see Paul George played at an MVP level, but they lost in the first round. You can say it's the shoulder injury, but he had the shoulder surgery, but then he had it on both shoulders. So I don't really know if we're going to see the MVP Paul George again. Was it just a breakout? Was it an enormous thing that he can continue to do? Or will we just see the same Paul George as one of the best players in the world? So we ain't going to take that for granted either. So when I look at these acquisitions, they're not really paying that much money. They're not really doing a long-term commitment thing either. So these are moves just to help them compete. It gives them some depth at the center position, give them some shooting with Mike Muscala. Obviously, ball handling duties with Alec Burks can get to the paint. I've always been an Alec Burks guy. I liked him in Utah. I feel like he can really give them somebody that can push the pace, create some shots for some people, knock down some shots, play off the ball. Give them a little cheaper version of Dennis Schroeder, not as effective, not as dynamic, but he can do some small things like him. I think at the end of the day, you do need a guard that can play some positions and give you some floor space. And hopefully Alec Burks can keep going with his three-point shooting. It was a couple seasons, but I got to see if he can do it for another 82 seasons. Another problem is he is injury prone because he does like to be physical. He does like to get to the paint, and that does tear down your body a lot when you're going against seven-footers and 6'7" people, especially at that shooting guard position when you're going against 6'7", 6'8" players and you got to bang with bodies and you got to try to finish it through contact. It do take some wear and tear, and we done seen it with Russell playing aggressive, trying to get to the paint, attacking. Do big collisions hurt? And hopefully Alec Burks can stay healthy and give them that three-point shooting at that guard position, and hopefully he can play when they go small and give him that shooting and that playmaking ability and that shot creation ability that he has. And if he does that, he can be a good acquisition for them for basically nothing and no long-term commitment. I like Nerlens Noel. He didn't have the best season with the Thunder. I kind of figured that they was going to bring him back. I thought they was going to give him a longer-term deal, but it didn't really happen. But he is a great pickup for them, a guy that's lanky, long, can play defense. I think his defense has slipped along as the seasons has went on, and the Thunder didn't really play him out at all. That's why I was surprised that he was really coming back for another deal when he didn't get that many minutes and that much opportunity. If I'm the Thunder, this is a steal. You get him basically for nothing, no long-term commitment, just like I said about Burks. And on top of that, Nerlens Noel is a quality player and a good backup big. I thought he would be a starter. I thought he'd try to go get a max contract. He went to the Mavericks. That didn't work out. He turned down that extension. And now he got $1 million, and now he about to get it again. So he lost a lot of money in a long-term guaranteed contract with the Mavericks that he turned down. And now he's getting less money and less commitment, and anything can happen. So he's not secure long-term, and injuries can happen, and it can really hurt him staying in the NBA, especially if he never evolves or become a better offensive player or become back that defender that we thought he could be when he got drafted. But Nerlens Noel is still solid, and he already knows the system. He knows the culture. He knows the players. He knows what they're trying to do. So you don't really have to bring him in. He knows it already. And like I said, I like Mike Muscala. I just want to see how they use him. I really want to see if he's going to get minutes, and I really want to see is he going to give them that stretch four that they've been trying to find so desperately that they continue to fail to get, or they don't ever live up to the hype,
where they just don't fit as well as they thought they would. And shooting is hard. Shooting is the hardest part of the game. The further shot from the game, I mean, the further shot in the game is a three-point shot. So I understand why it's hard to do it, especially when you got Paul George and Russell holding the ball a lot and you only can really get the shots that they give you. If they don't give you a shot, they're taking the shot. And that could be kind of hard to play with. We've seen that with Kevin Durant. Him and Russell play your turn, my turn. You go isolation, I go isolation. And if we make the shot, we make it. If it's late in the shot clock, we dance around and put in the ball and put the ball in the basket. If not, dump it off to Steven, kick it out to a shooter, let them throw up some bull. And if it go in, we win. If not, we just do it in isolation. If that go in, then they was a tough team to beat, but that's not championship formula. They went to the finals, but that year they had James Harden too in surge. They don't have that no more. They got Steven Adams. They got Russell. They got Paul George. They got a solid bench, but they haven't been out of the first round. They haven't made a real push for the playoffs either in the regular season. So I really want to see what Sam Presti do with this team. I feel like they got depth. They got the stars. They're just putting it together to where it works. Is it the coach? Is it Russ? Is it Paul George? Is not enough ball movement, not enough shooting? You done heard so many excuses, and I really want to know what's the real reason why they're not winning. What's the real reason why they keep trying to find the same stuff, and once they get it, it never really pans out for them. So you can keep saying they need shooting. They had Paul George and Carmelo. That didn't work. Then they said it was Carmelo. That didn't work. That he's gone. They didn't win 50 games. They got put out of the first round without him. Russ need help. He got his help with Paul George and Melo. Didn't work. Got Paul George, and it still didn't work. So now the excuse is Paul George had injuries. Russell had injuries. They got the surgery, and now I want to see what they really do. They got a lot of talent. They got a lot of cap turned into this team, and this is the roster they basically got to work with unless they trade Dennis Schroeder or Steven Adams. And if that's the case, I think they get worse unless they get an aspiring contract player that can contribute and give them salary cap relief at the end of the season. But it's still going to have to eat it if they keep them. So they're in a tough situation, and they really need their stars to play like superstars at this point and really make a big playoff run this season. If not, this is going to be one of the overrated duos, and this could be very dangerous for the Thunder in the future if they can never really figure it out. Kind of makes you think, what happened if Paul George would have went to somewhere else? What happened if he would have left in free agent to a different team? Because it hasn't really worked out with Russ these past two seasons. But they still got more time to figure it out. And now that they're in cap hell, they're in a tough situation to even get out of that. So I really want to see what Sam Presti do. He's one of the best GMs in the game. He know how to replace talent. He knows how to get fit. They just got to get some way to work it all out, make it all mesh, and get the job done. Let me know, are these underrated pickups? Do you think I'm sleeping on somebody? Do you think Nerlens Noel fits? Do you think Mike Muscala going to have a breakout season for him? Do you think Nerlens Noel has a breakout season for him? Do you think Alec Burks is a good fit? Do you think he can play with Russ and Schroeder? Do it give him backup for Russ and Schroeder if they get injured? And I think that these are good fits, good players. I just want to see them win. I just want to see them play in the playoffs and win and go on a run like we've seen other teams do. That's all I'm saying. As a person that likes what they do, I like Sam Presti. I like the Thunder. I just got to see them put it all together and get it done and get it right, which we haven't seen. That's all I'm saying. So let me know what you guys think about these acquisitions and the Thunder's future in the comment section below. Check out my Facebook page, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Check out my website, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Thanks for everybody that likes on Facebook. Thanks for everybody that likes the videos. Thanks for everybody that comments. I like the activity that you guys have shown. I answer comments that make sense, if that makes sense. And also, at the end of the day, if you like this video, check out my older videos on my channel. I have many playlists. I break down rookies. I break down players. I break down summer league. I do cover the draft, and I got a mock draft up already. Not only that, I do podcasts, and I also talk about the game of basketball, whether it comes to summer league, free agency, trade deadline, buyouts, and also I cover top 10 discussions and stuff like that. So if you like this type of video, you like the NBA, check out my older videos and my playlists. I enjoy making these videos. You guys enjoy watching. I'm going.